Challenge and context, the link between electricity and environment. In this video, we will talk about the link between electricity and environment. At the end of this module, you will be able to describe the link between electricity and environment, list EU strategies in the energy field. Energy is required for a wide range of activities, such as transportation, appliances, production, communication, growing and harvesting food. This energy has to come from somewhere. Natural environment provides initial energy sources, or so-called primary energy. It is the first relationship between energy and global climate. Primary energy sources can be classified into two groups. Carbon dioxide, or CO2, producing primary energy such as oil, gas, and coal. Low or zero carbon primary energy, such as wind, solar, hydro, and nuclear. Each source has its specific energy conversion units with their strengths and weaknesses. But the biggest portion of our energy comes from burning fossil fuels. Fossil fuels contributes 80% of the global primary energy used. Despite the numerous global economic crisis, the world's primary energy demand has continued to grow over the decades, and so has the CO2 level in the atmosphere. But why is there such a strong correlation between energy and CO2? In order to generate energy, conventional primary energy sources as fuel is converted by energy systems to energy carriers. Most of the time, it just means that fuel has to be burned. As mentioned, 80% of the energy produced follows this principle. The released energy is used to heat houses and to transform it to kinetic energy, which in return turns our engines to move a car or generate electricity. But whichever type of energy we consume, if we burn conventional fuels, it will still produce CO2. Although the electricity demand is globally on the rise, Europe is one of the few regions that has been able to reduce its primary energy demand. The European Union is committed to the deep decarbonization pathway. With this strategy, the EU aims to reduce greenhouse gas emissions twice as much compared to 2020, increase the share of renewables and energy efficiency by more than 50%, increase the EU-funded programs, help renewable production units come online with more interconnections, and reduce the land transportation carbon footprint by 30%. The EU sees development in these key areas. Energy efficiency. Deployment of renewables, also known as RES. Clean, safe, and connected mobility. Competitive industry and circular economy, infrastructure and interconnections, bioeconomy and natural carbon sinks, carbon capture and storage to address remaining emissions. It goes without saying that these ambitious targets need effort and strategic financing, and a question may rise. Are these plans and investments even feasible? To put it simply, yes. Starting from the energy security aspect, using more renewables resulted in a 16 billion euro saving on fossil fuel imports in 2015, and this is projected to rise to 58 billion euros in 2030. Another example of economic growth and added value for the European Union, the turnover of the renewable energy sources industry in 2014 was 144 billion euros. 1 million sustainable jobs were created in the EU only within the renewable energy sources industry in 2014. And if we take into account the improved air quality by burning less fuel, the health benefits and cost reductions in healthcare in the future will exceed the investments by a long way. On a more individual level, the EU long-term strategy, A Clean Planet for All, places a strong focus on decreasing overall energy demand and actively promoting Europe's transition to a low-carbon society. It will be achieved through energy efficiency improvements in buildings and electrical devices, and potentially changes in consumer behavior. The European Environment Agency says that behavioral change measures can deliver sustained savings of between 5% and 20% of the total energy demand. So make sure that you research your next purchase or home well, and you too can actively take part in the process of decarbonization. And remember, you are actually the most valuable player. Without your decisions and actions, well, nothing will change. To conclude, CO2 is connected to energy by the initial energy source, or so-called primary energy. The EU is one of the few to decrease its primary energy demand in the recent years. The European Union is committed to the deep decarbonization pathway. Your individual decisions are the most important. You form the rest of the EU, who decides the future of decarbonization. Thanks for watching.